Good morning, kids. I hope you all safe at your home. In our day-to-day life, to count things, we use numbers like 1, 2, 3, so on. The collection of this kind of numbers like 1, 2, 3, so on, we call this collection of numbers as natural numbers, and we represent the set of natural numbers with the letter N. So, N is natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. So, every natural number has a successor. Here, for example, 3 has got a successor 4. If you see 2, it has got a successor 3. And in the same way, the natural numbers except one, or the natural numbers, they have a predecessor. Okay, 4 is having the predecessor 3, but whereas 1 is having a successor, but it is not having the predecessor in natural numbers. If this collection includes 0 as well, then the collection 0, 1, 2, 3, so on is called whole numbers. We denote it with letter W. Okay? The smallest whole number is 0. 0 has a successor, but it has no predecessor in whole numbers. So, whole numbers are the set of natural numbers with 0 including 0. We call it as whole numbers. So, in this chapter, we are going to learn about this whole numbers. Next, we are going to discuss about properties of whole numbers. Number 1, commutativity of addition and multiplication. Number 2, associativity of addition and multiplication. Number 3, distributivity of multiplication over addition or subtraction. And the fourth one, identify for addition and multiplication. First, we see the commutative property of whole numbers. Commutative of addition. For example, 3 plus 5 equal to 8. In the same way, 5 plus 3 equal to 8. So, here we have two examples. 3 plus 5 equal to 8 and 5 plus 3 equal to 8. So, what is the difference? Here, the order of this whole numbers pair is changed. The rest is same. Because the numbers are same, but the order is changed. Here, 3 plus 5, here 5 plus 3. But the result is same. So, the sum of the two whole numbers, even though the ordering pair is changed, the sum, the value will be the same. This property is known as commutative of addition. So, the whole numbers are commutative in case of an addition. Okay? Therefore, addition is commutative for whole numbers. And next, now let us see multiplication. Okay, 2 into 3 equals to 6. 3 into 2 equal to 6. Here we have two whole numbers multiplied, we got a result product, and here the same numbers 6, 6. But the order of the pair is changed. Even though The order of the pair is changed. The result is same. So the whole numbers are commutative in case of multiplication also. So we can say that the addition and multiplication are commutative for whole numbers. Let's see some examples. 7 minus 3 equals to 4. 3 minus 7 equals to minus 4. That is, 7 minus 3 is not equal to 3 minus 7. So, subtraction are not commutative. Division. 12 divided by 6 equals to 2. 6 divided by 12 equal to 0.5. Therefore, that is, 12 divided by 6 is not equal to 6 divided by 12. So, division are not commutative. So, subtraction and division are not commutative. Addition and multiplication are commutative property. Okay. Next, we are going to learn the associativity of addition and multiplication. Okay. Now let us see. 3 plus 4 plus 5 is equal to 3 plus 4 plus 5. Here, 3 plus 4, 7 plus 5 is equal to 12. Here, now the same thing by changing the arrangement. 3 plus 4 plus 5, 4 plus 5 equal to 9, 3 plus 9 equal to 12. Okay, so here in this addition, the arrangement is different. Yes, in this case, in the first example, we added 3 and 4 first and then added it to 5. Yes, in the second case, first 4 plus 5 we added first and then we added 3. So we got 12 in the both cases. That is result same. Okay, even though here the arrangement and the order of addition is different. So, here we call this property as associative property. So, in addition, the whole numbers are associative. Okay. Now, let us see the associativity in multiplication in whole numbers. For example, 2 into 3 into 4 equal to 2 into 3 into 4. Here, 2 into 3, 6 into 4, 6 4s are 24. Here, 3 into 4, 3 4s are 12, 2 into 12 equal to 24. Here, in this multiplication, the arrangement is different. Yes, in this case, in the first example, we multiplied 2 and 3 first. Then we multiplied 4. Okay. In the second case, first we multiplied 3 into 4. Then we multiplied 2. Okay. But the result is same, 24. Even though here the arrangements and the order of multiplication is different. So here we call this property as associative property. So, in multiplication, the whole numbers are associative. Okay. But subtraction and division are not associative. Okay. Next, we are going to learn distributivity of multiplication over addition. Okay. So, first, let me explain the distributive law of multiplication over addition. Okay. So, this property can be symbolically written as a into b plus c, which will be equal to a into b plus a into c. So here distributive law states that multiplying a number by the sum of numbers is the same as multiplying each number in the sum individually and then adding them up. So now let me explain this concept with an example over here. The example is 5 into 4 plus 3. So this can be written as 5 into 4 plus 5 into 3. Here first we add these numbers. 4 plus 3 equal to 7. So we get here 5 into 7 and we get the result as 35. Okay, and then now let us multiply the number in the sum individually. So here we get 5 into 4 plus 5 into 3. So that implies 5 into 4 is 20 plus 5 into 3, which is 15. So we get here 20 plus 15 equal to 35. So we get here both the values are equal, 35, 35. We can see that distributive law of multiplication over addition is a closed operation. Okay. Next, distributivity of multiplication over subtraction. For example, 5 into 4 minus 3, which is equal to 5 into 4 minus 5 into 3. Here, first we multiply these numbers, 4 minus 3 equal to 1, and next 5 into 1 equal to 5. Here, we subtract these numbers individually, 5 into 4 equal to 20, 5 into 3 equal to 15, 20 minus 15 equal to 5. Here, both the answers are same. Okay, so we can see that distributive law of multiplication over subtraction is also a closed operation. Okay. Next, we are going to learn the law's property, identity for addition and multiplication. Identity for addition. When a zero is added to any number, we get the same number. For example, 0 plus 12 equal to 12. 12 plus 0 is equal to 12. So, 0 is called the additive identity. Okay. Identity for multiplication. When we multiply any number by 1, we get the same number. For example, 1 into 12 equal to 12. 12 into 1 equal to 12. Therefore, 1 is called the multiplicative identity. So, 0 is called the additive identity. 1 is called the multiplicative identity. Students, in this class, we learned the four properties of whole numbers. The first one is commutativity of addition and multiplication, associativity of addition and multiplication, and distributivity of multiplication over addition or subtraction. The last one is identify for addition and multiplication. Okay, this is for your homework. Name the property being illustrated in each of the cases given below. I do the first one. 75 plus 34 equal to 34 plus 75 is the property for commutative of addition. Okay, others you can do it. Okay, submit your homework on time. I hope you all understood this session. Okay, thank you so much, kids.